Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. Now we are making video on programming in C. So now already we discussed about algorithms. Today we need to learn few examples for algorithms, how we need to write an algorithm. So firstly, find the GCD of two numbers, swapping values of two variables, summation of n numbers, generation of Fibonacci series, and reversing a given number. Very simple. For better understanding only, we are making these videos. So first one is GCD. GCD is nothing but greatest common divisor. So if you take3 and 7, the greatest common divisor is 1, because 3 has only 1 and 3 are the factors, and 7 has 1 and 7 are the factor, commonly 1 is there, so the greatest common divisor is 1. When we prove it, 3, 7, 2, 6, 1. So 1, 3, 3s are 3, 0. So this is, in this way we are calculating. Always the divisor is changing in repeatedly, so that first we need to in algorithm, first the first step is start and the last step is stop. These two are common for us. Next we need to declare two variables, those are m and n, for finding the GCD of two numbers. The two numbers are m and n, and keep it on mind finding the remainder. So r also we need to take one more variable. Next is read numbers into m and n whose GCD is to be found. So we need to read the values of m and n. After that, if one of the number is 0, then go to end. If any number is 0, so here we get 0, any one number is 0, then obviously it go to end. Otherwise find out the remainder m mod n and store it on r. If r is 0, then print n, which is the GCD of m and n, and go to end. If r is not 0, then assign value of n to m and assign value of r to n. Repeat steps 5 and 6 until r is 0. So already I explained in mathematics. So the next one is swapping of two numbers. So here also the step one is start and the step is stop. In between, we need to, when we are swapping one variable to another variable, we need to take two variables, that is a and b. And so additionally we are taking temporary variable. Why, I will explain in the latter section. So after that we need to read the values of a and b. Next is, now I will explain you, if a is equal to 10 and b is equal to 20, if I exchange mathematically a is equal to b, then it will be exchanged. But a is equal to b and b is equal to a, automatically the values are assigned. But in computer memory it will not take like this. So that what we are doing is, we are taking one temporary variable. Initially a value is 10 and b value is 20. So that what I am doing is assign value of a to temp. So here we need to assign. After that, next is assign value of b to a. Next, assign value of temp to b. So initially we take 10 and 20. After exchange, after swapping, the values of a is 20 and the value of b is 10. And we need to print the value of a and b. So next one is summation of n numbers. So the step 1 is start and the step 9 is stop. So first is declare three variables, n, s and I. N is how many numbers, and s is sum, and I is incrementation. Okay, read n from the keyboard and initialize s to 0 and I to 1. Add value of S to S and I and store it in S. Increment the value of I by 1. Repeat 5 steps 5 and 6 until I is less than equal to N. So print S automatically you will get. Simply what it indicates, for I is equal to 1 to N, initially S is equal to 0, so S is equal to S plus I. Finally we need to print S. This is the algorithm. For these lines, these are the steps followed in writing it. So next, generation of Fibonacci series. Before discussing about Fibonacci series, what exactly the series contains. The first value is 0 and the first value is 0 and the second value is 1. After onwards, sum of the first two will become 1, next two will become 2, next 3, next 5, next 8. So here this is first value, this is second value. This one is come under category of 0 plus 1. This 2 will be come with 1 plus 1. This 3 will be 1 plus 2. This 5 will be 2 plus 3. This 8 will be 3 plus 5. Like this, the series will be generated. For that, we are writing the code. So, declare the variables A, B and C. Additionally, we are taking it. Declare N and I. So, up to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I will give n is equal to 7, then it prints 0 to 8. Okay. Read the number of terms n and assign the value of a is equal to 0 and b is equal to 1 and c is 0 and I is equal to 1. Print the value of a. Assign value of b to a. Assign the value of c to b. Assign the sum of a and b to c. Print C. So simply I can say that here I also add that A and B. So we need to print first 0 and 1. After that, C is equal to A plus B. It means that the new value will be asset 0 plus 1, 1. We need to print C. Now what I am doing is, value of B is assigned to A. So A is equal to B and value of B is equal to, value of C is assigned to B. These steps are repeated until the I reaches the N minus. Okay. So the next one is reversing given number. So this is one of the little bit difficult concept, but I will try to explain you in a better way. So if you take 789 can be represented 700 plus 80 plus 9. When coming to the 700, 7 into 100 plus 8 into 10 plus 9 into 1. Again this is 7 into 10 square and 8 into 10 power 1 and 9 into 10 power 0. This is the way we are representing a number in mathematically. So with this concept, why we are dividing, keep on dividing with 10 will be understood by this. So the first step, when we take a number n is equal to 789, first what we are finding is the remainder. Keep on module with 10 and we take the remainder. So n mod 10 is stored with R, so that 789 mod 10 is equal to 9. So the value of R contains 9. We are splitting it. The next statement is reverse is equal to reverse into 10 plus R. Initially the reverse is 0. So here 0 into 10 plus 9, that is equal to 9. Next, n is equal to n by 10. So 789 by 10, that is equal to 78. This is the first stage. These three lines make the entire process of this. For this, R, N and reverse, REV reverse are the variables. So N, REV and R are the declaring. Next is, we need to read the value of N. Assign value of reverse to 0. Assign N module 10 value into R. So what exactly I am doing? R is equal to N mod 10. Next, multiply reverse value with 10 and add R to it. So that is the statement I make it. Store this value in reverse again. So divide the number by, divide by number N by 10. Repeat step 5 to 7 until N is not equal to 0. So print the reverse, automatically you will get the answer. Means this N will become 0. Now it is 78. In the next step it will become 7. And the next step N will become 0. Automatically the process will be stopped. Thank you.